What's up, Tiger fans? It's Morgan Thomas here, and we're going to do another Clemson commit evaluation, this time on Adam Randall. But before we do that, make sure you like and share this video, and let's get into it. With me tonight is Big Al, Allen Adams, and Houston Burnett, and we're going to discuss another commit for the Tigers, and that is Adam Randall, who committed none other day than Christmas Day to 2020, recruited by Tyler Gresham, 6'3", 198-pound wide receiver, four-star overall by 24/7 Sports Composite, ranked 181st nationally and 22nd overall as a wide receiver right now, from Myrtle Beach High School in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina, had 23 overall offers from Coastal, Georgia, Miami, UNC, Oregon, and South Carolina. But let's get into it. Houston, what were your thoughts on Mr. Randall?
You know, I love Adam Randall's game. He looks like a little bit bigger version of Cornell Powell initially. He runs good routes. He's very athletic on the edge, someone that you could play on the edge, play in the slot, a variety of different ways to use him. And you think about the offense that he came from in high school, playing with J.J. Jones and Luke Doty, and he was one of the primary targets that made both of those guys end up looking good in that elite offense down at Myrtle Beach. I think it's really rare for Clemson to offer in-state talent to begin with. So you know this guy's good. You see the jets on screen there. He's really fast. Like I said, translates more to a guy that you could probably use at slot. But also, I mean, if you want to send him on a go route, he's going to be just fine. Love what he does. I think it's perfect. Great pickup for the offense. Great first skill player for Clemson to get in 2022.
Yeah, without a doubt. Look, I like the fact that you can get an in-state guy. I mean, it's always nice. A lot of times you'll pick up what maybe ranked a lower in-state guy over somebody, you know, that's ranked a little higher out of state. There's something about getting that homegrown talent, and I like that in Adam Randall. So hopefully he'll be able to do some good things for the Tigers. I agree with Houston. I think he can profile it at several different receiver positions. I think Clemson can find out where he fits best. I personally think he would fit best in the slot, as Houston mentioned. I think he's got a little bit of wiggle to him, especially when he gets the ball in his hands. I like the way he can make some moves, tough to bring to the ground. He has good speed, though, too, as well. You can see that on his outside throws. He gets behind defenders regularly. That's something he does. He's able to get a lot of good separation deep. He's able to get really good separation, you can tell, especially when he runs those stop routes, those curls, and things like that, because he's beating them deep half the game. And when he pops that run and that does that short stop, you know, it's easy to get, you know, 5 yards of separation, and they're easy pitch and catch type deal. So he has good hands. He likes to catch the ball with his hands, which is something that's really important to me for a receiver. So that's something I like to see. What I want to see from him is, can he catch the one-on-one ball? Can he catch the jump ball? Is he able to do that? Is he able to catch it in heavy traffic? It's obvious he can go over the middle and catch a pass, but I want to know if he can do it with somebody draped all over him, you know, like a Mike Williams or a T. Higgins or somebody like that. That's kind of the only question I have with him going forward. Is he able to do that? But he's very impressive receiver, and glad Clemson got him.
Myrtle Beach went 13-1 in 2019 and 7-3 in 2020. Last season, he had 46 receptions, 1,011 yards, 9 touchdowns. And obviously, as you can see, he's familiar with the spread. I love his long strides. He gets past defenders, and it's like they don't even realize that he's 5 or 6 yards behind them before the ball goes up. He understands how to get at separation and use his speed to his advantage. But I wouldn't even – it's like he sneaky's fast, you know. He doesn't even really come off as a guy that would be fast, but he definitely gets past everybody and can do that often. You can see in the film there. I agree with Al. I would say more along the lines with the red zone. We see a lot of big time plays with this guy between the 20s, but kind of lacking in the red zone film. Now, that doesn't mean that he doesn't have it. We just don't see it in the film in the stuff that I've seen. So like to see that develop more. Like Alan said, that one-on-one, maybe back of the end zone type thing. Don't really see much back of the end zone or corner of the end zone stuff from Randall, but you definitely see a lot of big time plays between the 20s and an open field for sure. A lot of the plays remind me of a little bit of a mix of Ladson and Ngata, even though I will say that, you know, Ngata was like every single play was to the house, it seemed like in his film. But still, great film, great player, great pickup for the Tigers, and a great Christmas Day present last year. So look forward to seeing Adam Randall wearing orange. And again, if you like this video, make sure you like and share this video with your friends, and we'll catch you next time, Tiger fans.